Good morning, my dear students. It gives me immense joy and happiness to present before you 12th standard unit 1, the two gentlemen of Verona. I hope you all are keeping fine at home. Be safe at home. Obey your parents' command. Obey whatever your parents say. Be healthy. Going to the topic, the term gentleman refers to being reverent, being helpful, being courteous, being generous, doing selfless action. So these are the qualities that can be attributed towards a gentleman. There is a saying, never judge a book by its appearance. Appearance are deceptive. Yes, when we go through this beautiful story written by the great writer called A.J. Cronin, he started his career as a doctor, but later on, while he had been admitted in the hospital, he started writing a novel. Once his novel became very great, popular among the people, he gave up his profession as a physician and started his career as a novelist, and he became very popular among the people. Yes, my dear friends, the title of the story, Two Gentlemen of Verona. I explained the qualities of a gentleman. Now, what about the Verona? Where is Verona? What is the future speciality of Verona? It's nothing. If you read the stories of or the plays, the work of William Shakespeare, you will come across the city called Verona. Shakespeare too has written a beautiful story, the same title, Two Gentlemen of Verona, but that is entirely different. It has got entirely different story. Here, A.J. Cronin used his mind, his thoughts, his imaginative powers to write this story. This is Two Gentlemen of Verona. Sir, you may ask, where is Verona? Verona is a beautiful city in Italy. Most of the characters that Shakespeare has written in his plays revolves around Verona. What is famous in Verona? It has got many historical places. People love to visit the place. For example, the historical places that I am showing here. It has got the castle, the tomb of Juliet. Who is Juliet? One of the tragedy written by William Shakespeare is Romeo and Juliet. People believed that Juliet lived in Verona, a small castle. In a small castle she lived. And there we will find the tomb of Juliet. So in Shakespeare play itself, we have got two historical places where people go to visit such a place. This is attracted by all the people. Next, it has got a theater. Verona has got a big theater where people visit for a lively show, where the actor and actress come and perform here lively. So Verona is peculiar, remarkable place for the people, for the tourists to visit. As I told you, this story is written by A.J. Cronin, and he is A.J. Cronin. A man who dedicated his whole life for the people. He writes everything, being one with the people. He understands the emotion, the feelings of the people, then he starts to write. That's why his novels, his writings, everything became so popular. Before entering into the topic, can I say one thing? It's not only a two gentlemen, but if you ask me, it is a three gentlemen. Verona. Who is the other one? That's what we'll see in the story as the story goes on. I will give a summary of the story, then I will give the characters' explanation. The main characters in the story, Nicola, Jacopo, narrator, Lucia. These are the main characters in the story. Now, what is the theme? What is the message that author, the narrator, want to tell the readers? We can say the dedication, the love. What is the love? I have written only the word love, but selfless love, unconditional love, without expecting anything, we give ourselves, we work for others. So, selfless love, hard work of the boys. Next, the determination. What is determination? Willpower to work for hours and hours. I can. Where I have to do something. Devotion towards the work. What is the devotion? Devotion means a passion for the work. I should have a passion towards the work. Then only it will become successful. Otherwise, it's a waste of time. So, with these qualities, with this theme, let us enter into the topic. Two Gentlemen of Verona. You may ask me, sir, who is William Shakespeare? I have referred here about his play. As I said, the same title, William Shakespeare has written a beautiful story. He is none other than William Shakespeare. A man who is fondly called as the father of English literature. A great dramatist. Now, let us enter into the topic, Two Gentlemen of Verona. The narrator and his companion had been driving along the road to reach Verona. On the outskirts of the city, two boys, they stop narrator's vehicle and ask them to buy strawberries, wild strawberries. Who are these two boys? I will come and say afterwards. Who are the two boys? Yes. The driver is not even interested to buy because of the shabby appearance. He cautioned the narrator against buying strawberries from the boys. But narrator had another mind. He was attracted, impressed by the nature of the two boys. Though outwardly they look very shabby, dirty, but they are very serious. That's why the narrator shows that he is very kind and generous, and he buys the biggest strawberry from the boys. And he reaches the city. Next day morning, the same two boys, sits near square, in a public place. They were polishing the shoes. And this narrator was impressed by these boys. And he asked, what is going on? And he said, sir, we do many things here. We work as a guide, we escort all the tourists around the town. We sell fruits, newspaper. We polish the shoes. Okay, the narrator said, very good. What are the work that you do? I am really remarkable. On another night, it was almost midnight, the two boys were sitting on the pavement and selling the newspaper. And the narrator asked, "I see you many times selling these all things, but you are never worried about your dress. You are never worried about what you eat. Are you saving your money or your income, whatever that you have got, to migrate to America or USA?" And the boy says, the elder one says, "No, sir, we have got some other plan." The narrator does not want to intrude into the personal matter. And he says, the narrator says, "Sir, boys, I had been with you for a week. So, after a week, I am planning to move away from the city. Do you need any help from me? Can I do any help for you?" And the young boy said, "Sir, can you take us to Palato, some 30 kilometers from here? Every week we used to go and visit the small village called Palato. Can you take us in your car, sir?" The young boy said. And voluntarily, the narrator agreed to take them to the place. He drove the car, and as they reached the place after 30 kilometers, there the narrator happened to see a red roofed villa, which seems to be a big house. The two boys just opened the door and jumped out, and they gave a word to the narrator saying, sir, wait here until we come back. It will may take an hour. Until we come back, wait here." Then they rushed towards the red roofed villa. The narrator did not know what is happening here. Why these boys ran away there? And out of curiosity, slowly, the narrator moved towards the villa. There, he saw the two boys were sitting in a bed, and there is a 20-year-old girl was sitting there. And he inquired about these boys and a girl, and he asked the nurse, "What is going on here? Who is these two boys? What about the girl?" And he said, "Sir, this is what happened during the Second World War. During the Second World War, these boys, they remained, they had a beautiful house, but the Germans, they bombarded everything. They destroyed all the houses, they became homeless. But they built a small home to live there. Unable to live further, the two boys moved away towards the city for a livelihood. Now, their father was a great singer. Father was a great singer, even he too died. Sister Lucia wanted to become a great singer, but she was affected by tuberculosis of the spine. These two boys took her sister and admitted in this hospital. Every week they visit this hospital to pay for their sister's expenditure, namely for her treatment. Every week they come. And this narrator was taken back. He was shocked to see such a responsible person in this small age, such a devoted person in this small age. And he asked the nurse, "Don't reveal anything to these boys, that whatever you are revealed to me." With this, the narrator went and sat in the car. The boys came back for half an hour, and the narrator left these two boys. The story unfolds from the eyes of the narrator. Yes, my dear students, the story may end here. The narrator shows the devotion, the responsibility, the seriousness, the maturity, the selfless love of the two boys in the story. Outwardly, they may look shabby, outwardly they do not wear coat and suit to be a gentleman, but honorably, if you say, they are the two gentlemen of Verona. From the heart, from their work, the hard work that they do, from the dedication, from the devotion, we can say that they are the two gentlemen of Verona. As I told you, there can be third one, not two, three gentlemen of Verona. Who is the third one? It is a narrator himself. Narrator who is very kind, who is very generous, who is ever ready to help, is another gentleman. But the narrator had kept opting title, Two Gentlemen of Verona. Now, what we can learn from the story, my dear students, what the moral that we learn, the learning outcome, what is that? Never give up your hard work despite failures, hurdles, hardships, suffering, whatever comes on the way. Never give up. Keep on working, keep on working. That will take you to the pinnacle. Show your responsibility. Show your hard work. Really, everything will prevail and you will succeed in your life. Now, coming to the characters, from the exam point of view, they may ask you the characters of Nicola, Jacopo, narrator, Lucia. Now, who are these people? As I told you, as the narrator was entering inside the city, two boys stopped their car. Who are the two boys? These are the two boys. The elder one, Nicola, the younger one, Jacopo. Can you see what they are carrying? They are carrying some fruits. See, Nicola is 13 years old boy and Jacopo is 12 years old boy. He is very serious but very mature person. On the other hand, Jacopo, the elder, younger one, is very lively, childish behavior. They work day and night for their ailing sister who is admitted in the hospital. They are not worried about the dress, what they wear. They are very shabby, the tunic that they wear. They are not at all worried. They eat black bread, fixed. They sleep on the pavement. All for one cause. They are devoted towards their work. They want to save their lovable sister who is in the hospital. They show everything. So, these two boys, they work day and night for their ailing sister. And they are not at all worried about their outside appearances. Appearances can be deceptive. Never judge a book by its appearance. Never judge a book by its cover. Yes, my dear students, though outwardly they look shabby, they look very dirty, but they have got a tender heart. They have got a heart that can melt for the people. They are doing selfless service for the people, for the sister. So, these two characters are very important in our story, Nicola and Jacopo. They lost their father during the Second World War. Earlier, they lost a mother. Students, I just want to tell you what happened between Germany and Italy. During the Second World War, Hitler and Mussolini, Hitler from Germany, Mussolini from Italy, they came together to fight against USA, America. Combinedly, they came together to fight. After some time, the people in Italy not at all happy with the decision of the Mussolini. So, the people were against him. The people rejected the order of Mussolini. As a result, Mussolini withdrew his decision and came out of alien powers. Then Hitler had a war against Mussolini. He captured Italy. There he ruled for years and years. But later on, America comes to help Italy, and there Hitler was defeated. A new country was announced as Italy by the help of Americans. My dear students, this may be a small information for what is not in your book. When Germany was ruling Italy, when they were destroying all the houses, bombarding all the houses, at that time only Nicola and Jacopo lost their homes, lost their mother, lost their father. Even these two boys had resistance towards the movement. Even they too had resistance movements. Yes, these two boys worked day and night for their lovable sister. Next narrator, they may ask a question. Explain the attitude, the character of the narrator. Yes, narrator is a lovable person, very kind person, generous person. How can you prove that he is a kind and generous person? At the beginning itself, when the boy showed the strawberries, though the driver warned the narrator not to purchase from these shabby boys, but his kind heart, generous heart, felt, seeing the condition of the boys. They are very serious, they are mature people, and he bought the biggest basket of strawberries. There you can see his kind hearted. He is a very respectable person, never wanted to intrude into the personal life of the two, Jacopo and Nicola, never. When he came to know that they are working day and night for their lovable sister, never he wanted to intrude into the personal life. See the great man, see the respected man. Never. He said, I respect the privacy of the two young boys. This is something, a true character of a gentleman. Next, who is Lucia? A 20-year-old girl, their lovable sister, who wanted to become a singer like her father. Yes, she wanted to become a great singer, but she was affected by tuberculosis of the spine. Her brothers did not leave her and go away, but the affection and love, the care that they had for their sister, and she was admitted in the hospital, and every week they traveled 30 kilometers to see their ailing sister who is admitted in the hospital. Dear students, with the theme, with the introduction, with the character explanation, with the summary of the lesson, we come to a conclusion. What is the learning outcome of the story? What we learn? Why it is kept for you? It is nothing. When we are devoted towards some work, when we show our dedication towards the work, what kind of dedication? Selfless service, unconditional love towards the people, means the hard work of the person can bring anybody sitting here to the pinnacle. If you work hard, surely your hard work will take you to the highest peak. Dear students, like the Duke boys, Nicola and Jacopo, who is not at all worried about the outside appearances, but they work day and night for the lovable sister. In the same manner, never worried about your outside appearances, never worried about what the people say, never worried about what your friends, parents, your friend, etc., etc., whatever they say. But keep in mind, your goal is fixed. Reach your goal. Go. Keep on traveling, traveling, traveling. There may be hardships. There will be problems. Yes, we have to face everything to overcome all the problems, then reach the pinnacle. As these two boys never worried about their outside appearance, but they had to work day and night to save the life of their sister. Now you have to work, you have to study all the subjects to score the maximum mark in your board examination. This is the dream of your parents. So I hope and I trust you all will follow these virtues to be a successful person in the society, or to be an inspiration and role model for everybody. After all, this story is an inspiration for everybody. It can motivate you one way or other. It can inspire you to be great in the place wherever you are. So my dear students, be dedicated, show your selfless service, show your devotion, passion towards the work, and your hard work will take you to the highest peak. Thank you.